Over 2,000 babies are born in the UK every year with a potentially life-threatening critical congenital heart defect. Almost 60% of these babies will not be identified before birth, and following birth, almost half will present with serious illness before the diagnosis is made. A third of these babies will be sent home without a diagnosis. Many of these babies will become seriously unwell, and sadly, some of them will die. My name is Professor Andrew Ewer. I'm Professor of Neonatal Medicine at the University of Birmingham, and I've spent the last 10 years developing a technique which can increase the detection of these babies to over 90%. The screening test we have developed involves the use of a machine called a pulse oximeter. Pulse oximeters are very common in hospitals. They're widely used to simply and non-invasively measure the levels of oxygen in the body. A sensor is placed on a finger, or in a baby's case on a hand or a foot, and the oxygen levels can be measured. We know that in babies with critical congenital heart defects, most of the babies will have slightly lower oxygen levels than normal, and the machine will pick this up. Once these babies have been identified, we can investigate them further to look for critical heart defects. We also pick up babies with other conditions that lead to low oxygen levels, such as breathing problems and infections. We know that if we introduce pulse oximetry, and we have done work on studies involving over 500,000 patients, that this test is very consistent and increases the detection rate of critical congenital heart defects to over 90%. In addition, we pick up other conditions which may be equally important. Our test has been adopted now in the United States, and currently every baby born in the United States, over 4 million babies a year, receive this test. In the UK at the moment, about half of the hospitals are currently using the test to screen babies, so that means half are not. Whether or not all babies in the UK receive this test depends on the National Screening Committee. The National Screening Committee in the UK decide on all screening tests for babies, and recently they reviewed the evidence for pulse oximetry screening and decided not to introduce the test. This is very disappointing, but importantly, the National Screening Committee have announced a public consultation in which parents, patients and health professionals can share their views on pulse oximetry screening. I think this is really important, and it's a great opportunity for us to influence a decision. Why does the National Screening Committee think that pulse oximetry screening is not a good idea? They're mainly concerned about the lack of evidence that pulse oximetry improves outcomes, although for heart defects, the evidence that it improves the outcome is overwhelmingly demonstrated in the study from the United States. For the other conditions, breathing problems and infections, it's less clear whether there's a benefit. And because of this, the National Screening Committee convened a work group of expert neonatologists and other health professionals to debate the pros and cons of screening for these conditions. The findings of that committee can be found on the National Screening Committee website, but essentially they decided that overall the benefits of pulse oximetry screening outweighed the potential harms for these important conditions. When we talk about harms in screening terms, what we mean is things like delayed discharge, parental anxiety, unnecessary tests and investigations, and unnecessary treatment. These are all really important things to consider, but in our analysis of the UK data, we estimate that less than 1 in 1,000 babies screened will have unnecessary tests and investigations, and these babies' discharges will be delayed by less than 12 hours. Importantly, 3 in 1,000 will have a potentially important condition diagnosed, and these babies can be treated earlier, thereby improving their chances of earlier discharge and fewer complications. All of the details and more can be found on our website, the details of which you'll see below. I urge you to think about this. If you have a baby and you're worried about the test, if you have had a baby and your baby had the test, if you had a baby and your baby had a heart defect that was missed, what are your views on this test? Do you think it's important? Do you think the National Screening Committee should reconsider its decision? If you do, I urge you to go to their website, details of which can be found on our website, and contribute to the national consultation. It's really important, and I passionately believe that we have an opportunity to make them reconsider their decision and potentially save more babies' lives. Thank you.